Good morning. President Biden overseas this weekend for his first foreign trip as president, but he's facing some big challenges back home. While the overall situation with the pandemic is getting a lot better, it's looking more and more like the president may fall short of his goal to have 70% of the country vaccinated by the 4th of July. He's also faced some challenges getting his infrastructure plan through the Senate, with a bipartisan group of senators now hoping to finally reach a deal. That's just one of the topics our Kristen Eskow addressed in a one-on-one interview this week with Indiana Senator Todd Young.
We can still legislate in this country and do important things if we work together.
Senator Todd Young says he's holding out hope Congress can pass a bipartisan infrastructure bill.
I think the president should take an approach related to infrastructure like I'm taking with the Endless Frontier Act.
Young sponsors that bill, which passed the U.S. Senate days ago on a 68-32 vote. He says it's meant to make the U.S. more competitive against China in science and technology.
Ultimately, we need to outgrow, out-innovate, and out-compete the Chinese Communist Party. We can only do that by doing what we did post-World War II, which is investing in ourselves. Our human capital, like we invested in the GI Bill. We invested in people's training and education. This is a bipartisan measure, the most sweeping, toughest, anti-Chinese Communist Party piece of legislation ever.
Getting tough is what Young says he wants to see from President Biden as he meets with Russian President Vladimir Putin this week. The trip to Europe comes not long after Russian criminal groups were linked to massive cyber attacks.
One of the things that the President of the United States must communicate unambiguously to Vladimir Putin, perhaps communicate through action, is that we can punch back harder than we take a punch. We have an offensive cyber capability that could really be injurious to Vladimir Putin and to his cronies.
Young says both government and private entities need to step up their cybersecurity.
One of the things we have to recognize is the federal government isn't hardened to the extent we should be. We need to get far better at operational security, that is making sure that we're utilizing our devices and our computers in safe and secure fashions, that we have secure passwords, and that we have all the hardware installed that's needed to keep out others. In terms of being more outwardly facing and working with companies and individuals, we still have some work to do, and I look forward to working with private industry and others to take whatever measures are necessary.
Is that work regarding businesses going to need to include regulations to ensure businesses have the right protections in place?
Well, it may. We need to only regulate with our eyes wide open and in a fully informed way. Congress tried to address this working with the administration several years ago. And at the time, a decision was made to allow companies to voluntarily report attacks that they had experienced on their systems. We may have to rethink that.
And Dan, of course, cybersecurity, a big topic at the G7.
Yeah, no doubt about it. This week, world leaders talking about that and many other issues. A lot to talk about there with Senator Todd Young. A lot to talk about at the State House this week as
For sure. This week, I spoke with House Speaker Todd Huston and State Representative Greg Porter. Both had a lot to say about the state's efforts to bring more jobs to Indiana. And I also asked Speaker Huston about some of the other big issues on his plate in the next few months.
The most recent revenue report we saw, substantial gains in revenue and substantial tax revenues collected that were higher than expected. What was your reaction to seeing that revenue report?
Obviously very pleased. You know, the Indiana economy is running full steam right now. Talking to employers, the biggest problem we have right now is finding more workers. So that's a great problem to have. But in the short term, we also have to really make sure we're skilling up our workforce. You know, there are all sorts of jobs available, and skilling up our workforce for those advanced manufacturing jobs, those skilled labor jobs is critical. And we're heavily focused on that. We've been focused on that. And coming out of the pandemic, we really hope that we can meet the needs of our employers.
We always projected that we would have more revenues coming to the state of Indiana. So many times we kind of lowball where our projections are. However, we saw that trending way back in the last quarter of last year of more revenues coming to the city and to the state of Indiana. With the stimulus dollars coming in, the American Rescue Act.
What do you think that tells you about Indiana's economy right now?
Well, our economy is doing well, as well as the country's economy. At the rate that we're going, we usually project about 5% growth. At this point, it looks like through the federal government and the dollars that we receive from them, our economy is going to grow at least 7% or even more. There would be some ways that I think we may have to pivot because of all the dollars that the growth of the economy. What we're going to do with some of those dollars to help take care of the people within the state of Indiana. And it's something that I've said for the since last October, and particularly we're not broke. I think we're going to do better than what you anticipate. The key point is that what happens once we reach that $2.8 billion, almost $3 billion surplus, what are we going to do for the people of the state of Indiana? That's the bottom line. Are we going to sock it away and take it off the records and have a hip pocket type budget? Or are we going to look at minority health, other human infrastructure to generate capital needs or programs, so trust funds, so we can take those dollars and help those individuals within the state of Indiana?
A lot of the Republican lawmakers have weighed in on IU's vaccine mandate. What are your thoughts? Does this current vaccine passport law ban public universities from requiring proof of vaccination?
Well, I think the Attorney General made clear that it does. House Bill 1405, prevented that. I think, IU's heard loud and clear from myself and many people from out the state, around the state, so many people I've heard of that they have concerns with the policy that they've announced. IU's began that process of walking that back. Look, we're making progress every day on the pandemic. And I mean, cases are dwindling and so I think, there's a middle ground on all this. I think IU is just trying to get the needs to work itself back to that middle ground.
Do you have any response on the governor's lawsuit against the General Assembly regarding your ability to bring yourselves back into session?
I don't.
Redistricting. Are there any concrete plans yet about whenabouts you'll be coming back into session for redistricting and what that process is going to look like?
No, because we don't know officially when we'll get the data back. We've heard we might receive that data at the back end of August. We'll see if that holds true. We'll begin the process of doing statewide meetings and a listening tour sometime this summer to get people's feedback on what they'd like to see. And we'll follow the process that we followed largely in 2011 as we did redistricting. But timeline is unsure yet. We really can't do anything until we have that data.
Sure. Some people have been concerned about the fairness of the process. What would you say to them on that?
We will follow all federal and statutory laws and regulations around it. I'm quite comfortable with it.
All right, Kristen, that whole legal battle between the governor and lawmakers, though, House Speaker didn't have much he wanted to say about that.
Right, he didn't. And of course, we could be hearing more next week about where things stand as that issue goes in front of a judge in Marion County on Wednesday.
All right, Kristen, thanks. Welcome again. No doubt a lot happening for lawmakers this summer already.
Sure thing.
Normally a quiet time of the year, not so much this year.
Right.
Thanks for having it all covered for us this week.